the ship sailed and they reached the other side. Listen at this. Watch Jesus. When you want to know how to keep going, when you don't know how to keep going, watch Jesus. He came out of a storm. He arrived onto the other side. He arrived into the city of Gerasa. And this one, he got there, he had come a crazy man. Hallelujah. Running up to him before he can set foot on dry land. There's another situation. He came, oh Jesus, I know who you are. What do I have? It's not your time yet. It's a funny thing when a person can know so much and don't know how to get out their own mess. Hallelujah. Tell me somebody. He knew that it was not Jesus' time to show up, but he didn't know how to get out his own mess. But the Bible teaches us that this man, hallelujah, he had an issue. He had a crisis. Hallelujah. He had the devil in him. He had some demons in him. And he just went on day and night. Folks trying to chain him and put him in the graveyard where all the dead folks are. But he just caught up himself. But when Jesus stepped foot, he immediately attacked Jesus. Jesus, look at him. I'm not going to preach this stuff, but it's going to give you some encouragement. Jesus, look at him. Say, what is your name? You know, sometimes you don't need a whole long conversation with the situation. If somebody's want to live in the mess, it's no long how long you try to talk to them. It's not going to help them. You just want to get down to the real fact and just tell them, what is your name? And he came out and said, our name is Legion. You don't want to mess with us, Jesus, for there are many of us. The word legion represents the Roman army, which had about 3,000 to 6,000 soldiers. So let's just say, for Texas, that there was over 3,000 devils in this world. Y'all gonna hear me? Over 3,000 devils in this one man. And he confront Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus said, come out. Come out, come out. Come out. Look, I'm not gonna argue the point with you, but just come on out. And when they find out that they couldn't win, they even pressed their way. They said, now Jesus, send us into those pigs. Don't kill us. Don't destroy us. And Jesus gave him their request. Well, my brothers and sisters, it didn't stop there. Hallelujah. Now this, before the words finish, the Bible says, there come a ruler from the house of the ruler from the synagogue. A man that represent the ruler. And I say, the daughter of the ruler was dead. And while Jesus, between the writing of Matthew and the writing of Luke, we find that they said that Jesus, hallelujah, on his way to the ruler's house, hallelujah, they come this woman, a certain woman who had an issue of blood, who had a situation that she was going to the doctor. I'm almost through here. If I just could get somebody to be a witness that I'm pressing my way, I'm going forward. She's been traveling to the doctor for 12 years. Oh, you know how it is. We sometimes complain. I'm going to the same doctor, but I'm not getting any better. You look at the medicine. You don't want to take the medicine anymore. But I'm so glad. But the Bible tells us you got to press your way. When things don't look good, you need to keep on pressing. Are you going to pray with me? I'm kind of closed here. So she kept on pressing. And the Bible says she heard about Jesus. Is anybody in here? I've heard about Jesus. You heard that he You were dealing with her issues. We can't give up. We gotta deal with it. Because that's going forward. And she said, if I fucking touch the hem of his garment, I'll be made whole. Is anybody in here just holding on? You're just holding on. Trying to push away. You feel like giving up. You have done everything that you know how to do. yes, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, I wish I had the fire to help me a little bit. He said, he is holy, he is magnified.
Ah!
church.